Thank you, Mr. President. And I'd like to speak in strong support of this resolution today and thank the good lady from the 37th for bringing it forward. Over the weekend, I thought a lot about Reverend King's legacy and how the good doctor would feel about the events of the last year and the way we behaved collectively as Americans. And I think he'd find room for disappointment. But first, I'd like to reflect on his legacy. And it's always a little disappointing to me that this gets politicized as disparate groups try to lay claim to Dr. Martin Luther King's movement, who's more appropriate to bear his mantle and who best reflects his values and messages. And I find that distressing and self-serving because it's my own opinion that nobody owns the legacy and everybody owns it. Martin Luther King's legacy is an American legacy that's built into the fabric of our society in a permanent and positive way. Mr. President, you made some comments at our first session that I really appreciated, and they were, and I'm paraphrasing here, setting a standard for us to treat each other with patience and grace. And that's what Dr. King would want for us during this distressing and divided time. Dr. King was thoughtful and gracious and pragmatic, and he wasn't about making things better for some people at the expense of others. He was about improving all of our lives by ensuring opportunities and law and justice are equally available for all our citizens. And this is an environment which a truly great nation will flourish. So today, I hope we take this advantage, take advantage of this opportunity to follow the example the great man set for all of us. And at the top of that list was his adherence to nonviolent civil action, something he and his supporters suffered for, and some greatly. Over the past year, we've seen violence in our cities, burning, lootings, injuries, and deaths. And we all know this is not the way of Dr. Martin Luther King. As leaders in our state, it's our duty to set the example against violence whenever and wherever it occurs and against whomever instigates it. Our response should be united, rapid, and uniformed, or equality under the law will have no meaning. And I would close, Mr. President, with once again thanking Senator Saldana for bringing this resolution before us.